Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Latifa, and in case you're wondering what today's video is all about, keep on watching because today I'm going to be taking you through 7 steps when it comes to designing your dream space. So this space could be your bedroom, could be your living room, could be your entire house, whatever space you have and you want to know exactly what steps you need to take to design it from start to the finish, then this video is exactly meant for you. So keep on watching. Designing a room can be frustrating and can be hard at times, but it's not as hard as maybe you may be thinking. It's actually very simple. Once you have steps to follow through, everything else just becomes easy and you find everything just flowing and everything just falling into place. So make sure to take these steps seriously because they definitely play a big part in designing a right and a good functional space that you're definitely going to love, you're going to enjoy, and it's going to be functional for you at the end of it all. So with no further ado, let's get started. So the first step that you need to take when designing your dream space is of course determining the purpose of your room. So this is something that is very important, something that is very crucial, and this is the first step that you need to undertake before anything else. Don't rush into buying anything, don't rush into doing anything. First of all, just determine the function of your space. So first of all, you need to identify the kind of activities you're going to be doing in that particular room. If it's the living room, you need to you need to ask yourself, is it a space that I'm going to be lounging more and watching TV, or is it a space that I'm going to be entertaining more? Is it a space that I really want to have conversations with people and all that? If it's a bedroom, then of course you also need to understand and know the kind of a function it is. You don't just say, fine, it's a bedroom, so I'm just going to put a bed on it and that's it. First of all, is this bedroom for a baby? Is this bedroom for an adult? If it's a bedroom for an adult, then of course, you know, there are essential things that you need to have for you to have a functional bedroom that actually serves your purpose and your needs. So determining the purpose of a room really helps you a lot be able to bring the right thing in that particular space and be able to design it the exact way that it's supposed to be. So the second step that you need to take is, of course, measure your room. So this is a very important part. Reason being, once you determine the purpose of your room, it becomes so easy for you to be able to measure. So ensure that you measure your walls, your windows, make sure you measure your doors, make sure you measure every single thing in that particular space. And also, other than just measuring the space of the room and how big it is, ensure that you also measure, you know, how big of a sofa you want. For instance, if it's a living room, make sure you also measure the size of your table, your coffee table, your media console table, the size of your accent chair, the size of your side table. All those things need to be measured because, you know, it helps you avoid buying things that may not fit in your space. And you want to ensure that you have the right objects and the right furniture in that particular space. So measuring your things before buying helps you avoid a lot of back and forth buying, which may end up making you or forcing you spend a lot of money that sometimes you don't even have in your budget and all that. And this also helps you be able to know exactly how things are going to flow in your space and where what particular item is going to go to and how big of a space you're really going to have or is going to remain for you to be able to move around and all that. So the step three of designing your dream space is definitely performing an inventory of already what you have in your space. So it's very important when you have already inventories that you've had maybe from your previous home or maybe you bought beforehand and all that, just try to see what you already have and try to see how they're going to play part in that present space that you have at that particular time. This is a great time to be able to separate the things for donating and the things that you want to keep. So of course, for the things that you want to keep, these are things that you still find them very valuable, you find them very important, and you still need them in your space. And the things that you want to donate, these are things that maybe they are very worn out and things that you don't like anymore and you'd want to donate or even throw them away if possible. A good way to be able to perform an inventory of what you have is just trying to understand what kind of things do you have. So for instance, maybe you may have a console table that maybe is traditional. You may have maybe, let's say, a bed that is modern, which is with a fabric headboard, or you may have a rug that is boho style and all that. So once you have these things in place and you already identify their styles and, you know, which group they belong to, it becomes so easy for you to, you know, mix and match these things to fit the kind of style that you want to have in that particular space. And don't be shy to be, to, you know, to play around with different designs in different places, because actually interior design is all about creativity. It's all about, you know, bringing in different textures, bringing in different styles and looks that, you know, that you like to co-marry together and give you a very unique and nice design that works perfectly for you and not anyone else. The fourth step that you need to take, of course, when designing your dream home is choosing the right design style that works for you. Previously, on my third step, it was all about performing an inventory of what you have and putting them in various design styles that they may belong to. Now, step four is all about choosing the right design style that works for you. So we have a variety of design styles out there, and they actually are countless, and it's up to you to decide and come up with one design style or two or even three design styles that work perfectly for you. So how are you able to choose a design style that works well for you? First of all, you need to look at different styles and see what they have, see how they style their rooms, and be able to maybe pick or pinpoint some of the styles that you love and some of those things that really stick out to you and that you really love and you really admire, you know, having in your spaces. In that way, then try to look at where or which group of design styles they belong to. And in that way, you have a clue or an idea of exactly the kind of design style that you really love and would really work best for you. So in this way, then you're able to, you know, choose or even buy things that are within that design style, and you're able to plan and design your space, you know, guided by that particular design style. Remember that different design styles come with different color schemes. They come with different designing styles, different textures, different materials and all that. So this really helps you narrow down to be able to get the right things that fit that particular design style. Choosing a design style really helps you narrow down a lot of things, and it saves you a lot of time and a lot of confusion when it comes to shopping. I know sometimes when you don't have a design style, you just find something that you like and you're like, oh, let me just have this. Oh, this is on trend, let me get this. And at the end of the day, when you bring it in your space, it doesn't really serve the purpose, or you don't really end up loving it, and you've already spent money. So you want to ensure that you're spending money in the right things and in the right styles that are really going to bring life to that space and that you're going to enjoy having in your environment and all that. So the fifth step that you need to take when designing your dream space is definitely choosing your color palette. So you've already chosen your design style, so the next thing you need to come up with is a color palette. And this plays a very big role in being able to, you know, buy the right accent colors, buy the right color of furniture, buy the right color of rug, you know, just being able to understand, you know, how you're able to play or place different color palettes in that particular same room. So a great way to be able to actually get the right color palette for your space is, of course, creating a mood board. And this mood board is going to, you know, have different colors of what you may want to have in your space. And this will help you be creative enough to know exactly which color is going to go on the rug and what color from the rug are you going to pick and have on your throw pillows and maybe have on your curtains and maybe have on your throw blankets and all that. So just having the right color palette is a great way to be able to have the right things in your space. Again, if maybe you're confused and you have no clue of what you want, then you can always go for maybe a material or a rug that you love with different color patterns in it, and then from there just try to pick different colors in that same rug or in that same material, and then just try to disperse it in your house. And I promise you, you're definitely going to have that nice seamless look that you want to have when designing your space. So if you're that kind of a person who doesn't really want too much color or many colors in your house or in your space, you can always choose to go for monochromatic color scheme, which is choosing one color palette and then now taking different shades of that same color palette in different aspects of your house and putting it in different places in your house and all that. And now on to step 6 is, of course, buying the necessities first. So as much as you have all these things in place, everything else is in place and all that, sometimes you may find maybe you don't have the budget to get everything at once in your space. And one way to actually do this is ensuring that you buy the necessities first. So it's not a must to have everything bought in one day or at a go. So sometimes, budget really restricts you. And what do? As long as you have everything else put in place, everything else is in record, then you can always refer back and buy things, one at a go. So for instance, if it's a bedroom, a bed is a must, as in you cannot sleep on the floor, right? So you need to ensure that you have a bed, you have a comfortable bed that you can sleep on. Then, you can always bring those other things later on in your bedroom and all that. If it's a living room, then you also need, because a living room is meant to, for lounging and sitting, you can always ensure that you have a sofa before anything else. All those other things will come in later. So if it's a kitchen, just try to ensure that you have the, appliances that are more important to you, and then maybe you can change this hardware or your cabinetry or whatever thing that you want to update later on. So just take a day at a time and just do what is important to you and what you feel you need at that particular time. So just try to be very careful and take your time when you're shopping for your things. Don't be in a hurry to buy these things at a go, and just go with the vibe, really. Just go with what feels right for you. And remember, because this is your space, just try to make it, your own and nobody else, because you're the one who lives in that space and no one else is going to live in the space at the end of it all. Now we are at the last step and the fun step, which is buying your decorating accessories. So this is the place whereby, you've done all the hard work, you've done all the frustrating work, you've been able to measure your room, you've been able to figure the function of your room, you've been able to come up with a design style that really pops out of you, that you really love and adore. You've been able to choose your color palette through your mood boards and all those things. So now, it has come that time to buy your, decorating accessories. So this is where now you're able to splurge a little bit and get things that, will take your room to that next level by making it now feel homey, making it feel more calm and more inviting. So decorating accessories could be things like wall art. It could be things like, your decorating books, decorating pots, flowers, plants, throw pillows, your throw blankets, your lampshades, your floor lamps. Anything that you may have that may decorate your space, this is the time that you need to buy it, because now everything else is set. So now it's all about just throwing few things here and throwing few things there, and everything just falls into place. And the advantage of actually having variety of decorating accessories is that you can actually change from one design style into a different design style using your decorating accessories only. Decorating accessories play a big part in just making your house feel fun. And the most important thing is that you guys don't forget that this is your house. At the end of the day, choose the things that speak more of the kind of a person you are and bring out your character. As much as you're shopping for your decorating accessories, try to ensure that they're within the color palette that you decided or you chose to go with at the end of it all. And definitely you're going to have that dream space that you're looking for and that you want or you wanted to have at the end of it all. So guys, that was it for today. Thank you so much for watching till the end of the video. And if you haven't subscribed, please make sure to subscribe. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. It definitely goes a long way. And other than that, I hope you're taking good care of yourself. Till next time, have a wonderful day. Bye.